What many people don't realize is that when a patient has cancer and gets treatment for cancer, sometimes that treatment can impact their ability to build a biological family. So for some patients, if they're receiving chemotherapy or radiation therapy or even surgery, what it might mean in the future is that they're infertile or unable to have their own children. So my role at Northwestern is to serve as the patient navigator for fertility preservation. So I basically see all newly diagnosed young adult patients here at our cancer center and talk to them about their treatment, how we think their treatment will impact fertility, and then also talk through the options of fertility preservation so that each patient understands and knows what options exist for them for family building. For female patients, they could choose egg freezing, embryo freezing, or an experimental option of ovarian tissue freezing. Some patients also choose to be treated with a medication like Lupron, which helps put them in menopause with a theoretical approach of potentially putting their ovaries to sleep to not have the chemotherapy do as much damage. It's a little bit experimental and we don't know much data about that. For male patients, they've got a few easier options. For most patients, they sperm bank, which is a one appointment visit, and then they can move forward with their treatment. If we're not able to collect sperm, we can also do something called a testicular sperm extraction, where our urologist will take a wedge resection and find sperm located within the testicle that we can then freeze.